Hi, ma'am. Welcome back. You've been gone for one whole week. How do you feel?
I'm still a little shaky, but it's my duty to report back as soon as possible. And I don't want the public to think I'm shirking my duty. So my first agenda item this afternoon was to try and make both parties appreciate the insistence by the public on a quick trial. We should not be geeks talking in a certain code among ourselves. Dapat malaman kung ano ang pinag-uusapan namin doon, yun ang gusto ng publiko. Kaya dapat pagbigyan natin din ang publiko dahil hindi lang naman purely judicial ang impeachment. It is quasi-judicial and it is quasi-political. Ngayon, ano pa ang kwenta kung tinitelevise at hindi naman nila intindi kung anong pinag-uusapan itong mga ito, ano itong mga Latin na ito, mga cases na ito. Kaya hanggang sa maaari, Kako, dapat magtagalog kami, lalo na kung importante na parte ng bista.
Right. It seemed like we needed you to call things into order. How do you feel about that?
Ay, sanay naman kasi ako, kaya may bentaha ako. Dahil 5 taon naman akong naging RTC judge, kasi alam ang problema natin ganito. Ang abogado, binabayaran per appearance. Hindi siya binabayaran ng lump sum. Kung hindi, bawat siya lumitaw sa korte, babayaran siya ng kliyente. Kaya hanggat sa maaari, pag nabayaran siya at nandyan na siya sa korte, magdadrama yan para sa kliyente. Para sabihin ng kliyente, 10,000 binigay ko sa iyo, yun lang, wala kang tinanong, kaya arte ka ng arte. Yun ang magiging sanhi ng pagtatagal ng kaso. Kaya ayaw ko sana mangyari iyon sa aming impeachment. Alam ko naman, kamukha lang ng lahat naman ng practicing lawyers na some of the things that are said in court are actually just for showmanship.
Right, right. And do you feel like we were wasting a lot of time last week? Did we waste a lot of time last week?
We could have hurried up the procedures if the prosecution were more prepared. That's why I asked both parties today to submit a so-called trial brief, which is really an outline of the witnesses and the documents that they would produce, in what order, what are the names of the documents and the witnesses, and what is the purpose of presenting that particular kind of evidence. Dahil kung meron na kaming trial, kopya ng trial brief nila, alam na namin kung anong dapat igigiit namin. Pero kung wala, hindi namin intindi kung saan papunta ito dahil paikot ng paikot.
Right. After your, shall we call it, a call to order this afternoon, Representative Tupas actually said something as well. At the end, parang yun din yung tinutuhok niya. He was trying to say the same thing that you had initially said. Do you agree?
Well, gusto niya, sabi niya, kung pwede daw, liberality. Eh, problema, there's no such term in the law, the rules of court. What is the meaning of, no, ang hiningi pala niya, not liberality, but flexibility. Ang ginagamit ng rules of court is liberality. Liberal refers to admission of evidence and the observance of procedures in general. You have to be liberal in the sense that if there all things are equal, if there's a question on whether you should admit the evidence or exclude the evidence, admit it. Para hindi magsuspetso ang publiko, may tinatago ka. Kaya, kaiba yung sinasabi ko na liberal, kaiba yung nasabi niyang flexible. Kaya sinagot siya ng Senate President, anong ibig mo sabihin ng flexible? What I actually meant is that when we interpret the rules of court in general, we should be liberal. But when we apply the rules of evidence in particular, then we should be technical.
I have 2 more questions.
All right.
One of our thought leaders on Rappler, Attorney Tedde, wrote about we can learn lessons from the Clinton impeachment trial, which lasted only 18 days because they had depositions. Uh-huh. Do you think it's something that we can adopt as well?
Yeah, we could have adopted deposition. Deposition simply means that you don't bring the witness to court anymore. Instead, you go as the lawyer together with the clerk of the court where the case is being heard, and then with a court stenographer, you take the testimony of the witness. That is called a deposition. And you don't have to present the witness in court anymore. Kaya kung marami kang witnesses na hindi naman napaka-importante, kunin mo lang lahat ng deposition nila, hindi na kami kailangan mag-google pa ng panahon na makinig sa bawat isa. Tama yon. That is a so-called procedure of discovery. Pero sa Pilipinas, hindi natin madalas ginagawa ayan. At saka, it's a little late now dahil nasa gitna na kami ng bista. Depositions are usually taken before the trial.
Last question. Now that you're back, what can the public expect from you and your participation?
Well, I'll try to hurry up the proceedings. That's why I asked them today on both sides to submit a list of the witnesses and what they hope to to prove by presenting these witnesses plus the document. Pag ganyan na, alam ko na kung gaano katagal dapat ang bista at kung ilan ang testigo bawat session. Hindi na iisang testigo lang bawat session. For example, if we have a certain number of witnesses and we already know that we want to keep the impeachment trial to only 3 months or just before Holy Week break, for example, then we can divide the time by the number of witnesses and there we get the formula on how many witnesses should be allowed to testify.
So you're gonna crack the whip?
Well, not necessarily, but if I'm provoked, I'm willing to live up to expectations.
And will the senator really expect any pickup lines from you?
Pag hindi siya masyadong nag-attention o nakikinig, isisubok kong isingit yun.
Do you have one for us? Do you have anything? anyone you can share?
No, not that.